Nirvisesha Shunyavari Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakalpataravyascha Kripa Sindhu Bayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're describing from the fifth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 18, prayers offered by the residents of Jambadweep. And we were hearing how the residents of tract of land known as in Harivarsha, the devotees there, led by Prahlad Maharaj, offer their prayers to Lord Nrisingadev.
上一次我们讲述的是来自哈瑞巴沙那里的居民，由帕拉德马哈拉吉代表的那里的居民向主尼辛哈德巴供奉的祷文。So,
Prahlad Maharaj and the other devotees there, they pray to Lord Nrisingadev that they don't want to become attracted or too much attached to family life and all the things which go with the family.
Prahlad Maharaj and Harivarsha那里的居民，他们祈祷道， 他们不想太依附于家庭有关的这一切事物。
And they pray that if we have attachment, our attachment should be for the devotees, whose only friend is Krishna.
他说， 如果让我有所依附的话，那就请让我对奉献者有所依附。我唯一的朋友应该是主Krishna.
A person who has actually got control over his mind and senses will live a very simple life.
一位控制了自己感官和心意的人，他总是过着最低限度的生活。
He does not try to satisfy his mind and senses.
他不会试图去满足他的心意和感官。
So in this way, he can advance in Krishna consciousness.
这样的话，他就会在Krishna知觉之中取得进步。
But if somebody is very attached to material things, then it's very difficult to advance.
如果一个人过分地依附于物质事物的话，他很难在Krishna知觉之中取得进步。
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was asked how to recognize a devotee.
有人问，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说如何去识别一位奉献者。
And Lord Chaitanya said that a devotee is one who gives up the association of the material.
主柴坦尼亚说，一位奉献者是放弃与非奉献者联谊的那一个人。
And he gives up the association of people who are very attached to material things.
这位奉献者也会放弃与那些过分依附物质事物的人联谊。
So Prahlad Maharaj also prays that he can avoid the association of people who are not devotees.
所以Prahlad Maharaj也如此的祈祷，他希望能够避免这些物质主义者、非奉献者的联谊。
He prays that he just wants to be attached to devotees. If he's attached to anything, let it be devotees.
他说，如果他必须依附某个人的话，他祈祷只依附一位奉献者。
So as long as we're in the material world, we have a material body, and we have to maintain it by devotional service.
只要我们还在这个物质世界，我们有一个物质的躯体，我们就得维系这个物质躯体。通过奉爱服务，我们维系这个躯体。
A devotee should only eat Krishna prasadam. He should not eat anything which is not offered to Krishna.
因此，一个奉献者应该只吃供奉给 Krishna 的 prasadam， 而不要吃非 prasadam.
And devotees should not eat too much. They should eat basic, eat simple.
奉献者也不应该吃的太多，他应该吃一些基础的，吃的简单。
If we become attached to satisfying our tongue and filling our belly, then it's very difficult to remember Krishna.
如果我们太依附于服务自己的舌头，让自己的胃感到满足的话，那么我们很难去想起 Krishna， 记忆 Krishna。
So then we'll never advance in spiritual life.
这样的话，我们会在灵性之中不会取得进步。
So we need to hear about Krishna and about Krishna's activities.
因此，我们应该聆听 Krishna 和 Krishna 的活动。
Because hearing about Krishna and Krishna's activities, it's so powerful that it will purify our heart.
因为聆听 Krishna 的活动是非常有力量的，它能够净化我们的内心。
So if somebody is constantly hearing about Krishna, and if he's always talking about Krishna, then it means he's always in Krishna consciousness.
有人是恒常不断的聆听，如果他恒常不断的讲述 Krishna 的话，他意味着就恒常的处于 Krishna 知觉之中。
The spiritual sound vibration enters his heart, and it takes away all the contamination from the heart.
这种超然的音振能够进入到他的内心，去除到他内心所有的污染。
But Prahlad Maharaj said, if we go and bathe in the Ganges, then that may help us to get rid of any physical contamination or infection in the body.
Prahlad Maharaj 还说，虽然我们在恒河中沐浴，它可以减少我们的一些躯体的外在的污染和感染。
And also, if you go to visit holy places, it also cleanses the heart, but it takes a long time.
如果我们去朝拜圣地的话，我们也能够通过朝拜圣地而净化我们的内心，但是这些方法需要花很长的时间。
But if you associate with the pure devotee, then very quickly we can get purification.
但是如果我们和一个纯粹的奉献者联谊的话，我们很快的能够净化内心。
Just bathing in the Ganges will help. It can help us. It can cure any diseases, infection we may have, any disease we may have.
如果在恒河沐浴，我们确实能够治疗我们的一些疾病。
But it cannot clean our mind of material attachment very easily.
但是它不是那么容易的能够净化掉我们内心的物质依附的这种心意。
But if we hear about Krishna directly, we hear about Krishna in the association of devotees, then that can purify the mind.
通过在与主的父 奉献者的涟漪之中，我们去聆听 Krishna 的话，那个就能够去除我们，清除我们内心的污染。
Because Krishna is within everyone's heart, so he becomes very pleased when a person hears about him.
Krishna 处在每一个人的内心，当有人去聆听有关他的讯息的时候， Krishna 会感觉到非常的被取悦。
Krishna personally cleans all the dirt from the mind.
Krishna 会亲自去除那个人内心中的污染。
We're in the material world because of all the dirty things in our heart.
在这个物质世界，每一个人内心都有很多的污染。
But if we can clean the heart, if we can get rid of all the dirt from the mind, from the heart, then we can become Krishna, we will immediately become Krishna conscious.
如果我们能够净化自己的心意，清除这些污染的话，我们便能立即恢复我们的 Krishna 知觉。
So Lord Chaitanya always gave great importance to hearing about Krishna, particularly hearing the holy name and chanting the holy name.
主 Chaitanya 总是很强烈地推荐这个方法，他希望奉献者能够聆听 Krishna 的名字，唱诵 Krishna 的名字。
So the Sankirtan movement.Chanting the holy names, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This cleanses, this is cleaning the mirror of the mind, cleaning all the dirt from the heart.
This Sankirtan movement, Hare Krishna Mantra, 就可以清除我们内心的这一面镜子，能够清除我们内心的污垢。
And then, when we clean the heart, then we become Krishna conscious, and we're better able to read books like the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam.
当我们的内心得到净化之后，我们就能够逐渐具有 Krishna 知觉。接着，我们就可以阅读像《薄伽梵歌》《圣典薄伽瓦坛》这些书籍。
And when we read these books, then we get a lot of purification.
当我们阅读这些书籍的时候，我们又会 越来越多的、更多的净化，得到净化。
Yeah, describes in the Srimad Bhagavatam. By regularly hearing Srimad Bhagavatam and serving the pure devotees, all the dirt in the heart is removed.
就像圣典薄伽瓦坛 1.2.18 中所说的，通过每一天有规律的聆听圣典薄伽瓦坛和向纯粹的奉献者做出服务，心中所有的污染都会被实际的摧毁掉。
So the devotee's heart becomes almost completely clean. Still a little bit remains because you need to also get the mercy of a devotee.
奉献者的内心几乎被完全的被清洁，但是他仍需要得到奉献者的仁慈与奉献者涟漪。
Because there's a, it's not 100% removed by hearing. It's a, removed almost to nothing. So there's still some imperfection, still some impurity there.
通过聆听几乎可以清除掉内心所有的污染，但是呢，还是会有一点点不是完全的，所以我们仍需要奉献者的涟漪给予这种仁慈，继续清除。
So this way devotee advances in Krishna consciousness. People have to hear. If they want to advance, they have to hear. They have to hear regularly.
如果人们想进步的话，他应该有规律的去聆听。
And the more we hear, the more we become attracted to Krishna.
我们越多的聆听，就越被 Krishna 所吸引。
So then Prahlad Maharaj describes very nicely how one who is a devotee will develop all the good qualities of the demigods.
Prahlad Maharaj 继续讲到，如果一个人是奉献者 的话，他会培养出所有的办事人的这些崇高的品质。
But a person who is not a devotee, who doesn't do devotional service, he cannot have any good qualities.
另外一个方面，如果一个人不是奉献者，不做奉献服务的话，他不可能会有很好的品质。
He may be expert at mystic yoga. He may be expert at maintaining his family, but he doesn't have any good qualities.
他或许非常擅长于做神秘瑜伽，或许非常精通于维系家庭、维系家庭生活，但是他不会有很好的品质，不会有好的品质。
Because he's only acting under the impulse of his senses, under the external energy, the material energy. So he's under the modes of nature. So he cannot have any good qualities.
So he cannot have any good qualities.
So we're all living entities, we're all parts and parcels of Krishna. We have an eternal relationship with Krishna. So when we become Krishna conscious, we should develop all the good qualities of Krishna. We won't develop them in the same quantity, but at least the qualities should be there.
We won't develop them in the same quantity, but at
least the qualities should be there.Worshipping, offering all these different processes of bhakti yoga, then they have to cleanse the heart.
如果我们做奉爱服务、聆听、唱诵、记忆、崇拜等等这些程序的话，我们就能够净化掉我们的内心。
So the result of doing all of these activities is that we have to develop the good qualities.
而做这些活动。最后净化内心的结果是我们就能发展出 Krishna 的这些品质。
One who is a devotee of Krishna must have good qualities.
一个 Krishna 的奉献者必须要有好的品质。
So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the author, Krishna Das Kaviraj, he lists 26 qualities of a devotee.
在永恒的柴坦尼亚经 Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami 描述了奉献者的26项品质。
And he says only by these qualities can we understand who is the devotee and who is not the devotee.
通过这26项品质，我们可以知道谁是奉献者，谁不是奉献者。
One who is a devotee, he must have these good qualities. One who is not a devotee, he won't have these qualities.
一个奉献者应该有这些品质，而不是一个奉献者他没有这些品质。
Things like being very kind to everyone.
第一个是他对每一个人都很仁慈，这是奉献者的第一个品质。
He doesn't have enemies.
他不与任何人为敌。
He's truthful.
他真诚。
He's very gentle and kind in his dealings.
他非常的慷慨，
温和。He's always clean.
他非常的清洁。
He doesn't keep hardly any possessions.
他没有拥有。
He's always thinking about how to benefit others.
他为每一个人的福利而工作。
He's always surrendered to Krishna.
他总是臣服于 Krishna.
No material desire.
没有物质欲望。
He can control his senses.
他
He won't eat more than required. And he offers respect to everyone. And he doesn't demand, he doesn't expect any respect for himself. He's friendly. And he is poetic. And he is often silent. So these are some of the qualities which devotees should cultivate just by doing devotional service. So one who is a devotee, naturally by chanting, by serving Krishna, he should develop these qualities. So then Prahlad Maharaj gives an example. Prahlad Maharaj is glorifying Lord Nrisingadev. He says, just like the fish always want to remain in the ocean, he said, the same way the conditioned souls always want to remain in the existence of Krishna.
Prahlad Maharaj 继续祈祷道，他也荣耀主尼辛哈德。 正如水生物总是渴望留在大片的海洋之中，水之中，所有受条件限制的生物自然渴望留在至尊主广阔的存在之中。
So someone may be very great man by material standards. Material world, he may be very important. But if he doesn't take shelter of Krishna, of the Supreme Lord, then his life is useless.
有一些人按照物质的标准，或许他非常的优越优秀，但是如果他并不脱离于至尊主的话，他的这种优越是无用的。
And his greatness, his position, big position in the material world, is just like that of a young, low class man and woman who are in love with their bodies. Sometimes you see, you know, the young man and the young woman, they're very much in love with each other based on their attraction to each other's bodies.
一些情侣或夫妇，他们非常依附对方的这种美丽的躯体。
So people who are in that condition, who are too much attached to the material world, they can't have any good qualities.
因此，一个人他过分于依附这些物质的状况、物质的世界的时候，他不可能有很好的品质。
Prabhupada gives the example. He said, just like the crocodile is very fierce and they're very powerful in the water, but when they come out of the water, they don't have the same power. So the same way, living entity, when they're in contact with the super soul, then they can show good qualities. But when they forget the super soul and lose contact with the super soul, then they have no good qualities.
同样的道理，这些生物如果它能够和超灵保持连接，它就会有很好的品质；如果和超灵失去连接，它不会有很好的品质。
Sometimes people in family life are well educated, they know about the knowledge of the Vedas, but they become attached to the material situation, to their family life.
And 但是他们却很依附家庭生活。
So they're like the crocodile out of the water.
他们就被比喻为像这个离开水里面的鳄鱼，没有力量一样。
They have no more spiritual strength. All their spiritual strength is gone.
他们所有的灵性力量将会失去。
Just like the young man and woman who are married and they're not very well educated and they become very attracted to each other, to the beauty of each other's body.
同样的，一对年轻的夫妇，他们没有受过教育，却彼此依附对方的躯体。
So that kind of attraction, that is for the low class people with no good qualities.
这种对躯体的依附是那种低阶层的人们。
So everyone should take shelter of the Supreme Lord. We shouldn't waste our time in material life.
每一个人都应该托庇于至尊主，不应该浪费他的时间。
Householder life is very short, very temporary. We shouldn't get too much absorbed in it.
居家生活非常的短暂，时间也非常的少。我们不应该太沉迷于居家生活之中。
And when you come to 50, by the time of 50, then you should be ready to retire from the family life.
当我们到五十岁的时候，我们应该准备着要退休了。
And retirement means giving up material duties and taking shelter of Krishna.
退休的意思是放弃物质的职责，托庇于 Krishna.
So Prahlad Maharaj is addressing the people there. They're all demons. You know, Prahlad Maharaj is the king of the demons there. And so he says, he says to his demon friends, he asks them, don't get too much affected by the happiness of family life.
Prahlad Maharaj is the 恶魔的这个国王，他就对这些人说，恶魔啊，放弃所谓的家居生活的快乐，不要太依附这种家庭生活的快乐。
Take shelter of Lord Nrsingadev, and he will protect you from all dangers.
完全托庇于主尼辛哈德吧，他会把你从所有的危险之中拯救出来。
But if you get stuck in the family life, that's a big attachment.
如果陷入到家庭生活中，那是一种很大的物质依附。
And it's very easy to get stuck in the cycle of birth and death again because of being in the family life.
陷入到这种家庭生活的物质依附之中，是导致非常容易导致重复的这种生老病死的轮回之中。
So that was Prahlad's prayers in Harivarsha. Now we're going to another place in Jambudweep, and we're going to hear about Ketu Malavarsh and the people there.
刚才我们聆听的是 Harivarsha Prahlad Maharaj 供奉的这个祷文。我们现在将聆听到的是 Ketu Malavarsha 这片土地上的。
And Lord Vishnu lives there in the form of Kamadev for the satisfaction of his devotees.
主 Vishnu 以 Kamadeva 的形体在那里显现，为了满足他的奉献者们。
And his devotees include the goddess of fortune, Lakshmi Ji.
这些奉献者包括幸运女神 Lakshmi Ji.
And then there's also Prajapati there. Prajapati's name is Samvatsara, one of the great Prajapatis.
那里还有 Prajapati. 那个 Prajapati 的名字是 Prajapati Samvatsara.
And he has many sons and daughters.
他有很多的儿子和女
The daughters are all controlling they're controlling deities of the nights, and the sons are controlling the day.
他们的女儿被认为是夜晚的控制的神邸，他们的儿子是控制着白天的。
And this Prajapati, he has 36,000 of his children.
Prajapati, 他们的后代，这位 Prajapati 的后代有36,000位。
But it means one for each day and each night in the life of a human being.
他们每一位掌管人类生命中的一个白天和一个夜晚。
Because people will live 100 years, say, and one year, 360 days. So, that means 36,000 days in the lifetime of an average human being.
他们控制每一个人的一天，总共一年有365天。100 years,
360 days in 1 year.
Oh, okay. 总共有一百年的话，生人按照人体生命有一百年的话，所以就是36,000天。
Yeah.
Oh,
so the Prajapati had 36,000 children, one for each day and each night in the life of a human.
Prajapati 后代的数量有36,000位，每一位掌管人类生命中的一个白天和一个夜晚。
And it's described at the end of each year, the daughters of the Prajapati, they get very agitated when they see the Supreme Personality of Godhead, when they see his effulgence, they see the disc, they see that the effulgent disc of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.And when they see that, then they all have a miscarriage.
在每一年的年末，这位帕加帕提的女儿一看到智者仁格守神，尤其是智者仁格守神灿烂的这个神蝶，就十分激动，他们遭受流产之痛。
So this Kamadev, this is Krishna's son named Prajumna.
这位 Kamadev.
Kamadev is name of Cupid. So this Prajumna also, he's like Cupid. He's very, very good looking.
Kamadev is Cupid, and this Prajumna is also Cupid. So this Prajumna is very, very beautiful.
So it's described that this Kamadev, that he is a Vishnu Tattva.That he's not an ordinary living entity, he's not a jiva, he's Vishnu Tattva. But his body is not spiritual, he has a material body.
This Kama Deva is Vishnu Tattva, but his body is not spiritual, but it's material.
But still, he acts spiritually. Although he has a material body, all of his actions are spiritual.
虽然他的躯体是物质的，但是他的行为却是超然的。
So it doesn't matter if he has a material body or a spiritual body, but if he acts spiritually, then that's sign of his that he's Vishnu Tattva.
所以不管他是一个灵接受的是一个灵性的躯体，还是一个物质躯体，都没有区别。他只要在进行着灵性的活动，我们就视他为是，视他是威士鲁塔的。
He can act spiritually in any condition of life.
在他生他可以在任何的受条件限制的情况下进行灵性的活动。
Mayavadis they even think Krishna has a material body.
Mayavadi 们，他们竟然认为 Krishna 也是物质的躯体。
Yeah, they think when Krishna comes, he comes in a material form. They cannot understand his spiritual position. They think he's an ordinary person who takes birth and who dies.
Krishna 显现的时候 ，Mayavadi 认为 Krishna 是物质的躯体，他们无法理解 Krishna 灵性的地位。他们认为主 Krishna 出生和死亡。
People think Krishna was shot in the foot by an arrow and he died, and this is where his body was cremated. You know, this is all foolish people. They have no knowledge about Krishna.
有人认为这个 Krishna 被箭射中，然后离开躯体。这些人的这些想法都是非常愚蠢的，他们没有真正的知识。
And they think Krishna takes birth just like we take birth.
他们认为 Krishna 出生就像我们出生一样。
So they have a very wrong understanding about the nature of Krishna's activities.
他们对 Krishna 的活动有非常错误的理解。
Okay, so we're going to hear about Ketumala. So Prajumna or Kamadev, he moves very graciously and his smile is very, very beautiful.
Prajumna or Kamana Deva, 非常优雅的行动者，他的笑容十分的美丽。
And so just when he moves his eyes and he glances around, he gives pleasure to the goddess of fortune.
当他微微地扬起双眉的时候，他非常取悦幸运女神。
So during the daytime, the sons of the Prajapati, they're the deities of the day.
在白天 ，Prajapati 的儿子们，他们是这个白天的控制者。
And at night is accompanied by the daughters of the Prajapati. They're the deities of the night.
夜晚在 Prajapati 的女儿们的陪伴下，他们的女儿是夜晚的控制者。
And Lakshmi also worships him during this period also.
Lakshmi 在这段时间也崇拜这个 Kamadeva.
And they're fully absorbed in devotional service, and they offer prayers to the Lord.
他完全沉浸专注于奉爱服务，供奉道门。
So we're going to hear how they pray to the Lord.
我们将会聆听他是如何。
They're praying to Lord Rishikesh, the controller of the senses.
他祈祷到 Rishikesh, 感官的控制之者。
He is also the origin of everything.
他同时是所有一切的源头。
And he is the master of all the body and mind and intelligence, the activities of the body and the mind and the intelligence, he's the master of all these things.
他是所有躯体、心意、智力活动的至尊主人。
And he's the actual enjoyer of all results.
他是结果的唯一享受者。
He provides all the necessities of life.
他提供所有的生活必须。
And he is the cause of everyone's body and mental powers.
他是每个人身体和心理力量的起源。
The purpose of the Vedas is to worship him.Therefore, the devotees, they pray to him that may we always be favorable. May you always be favorable towards us in this life and in the next.
所以他祈祷到愿至尊主在这一生和下一生总是体恤我们体谅我们。
So in the Bhagavad Gita it's mentioned like that, of course, how Krishna is the cause of everything. He's the taste in water, he's everything is from him. So this particular verse which we were just telling, this was composed by the goddess of fortune, Rama Devi. And it said, everybody who is under the shelter of a spiritual master, they should chant this mantra and become a good devotee of the Lord. By chanting this mantra, we can get liberation from material life. And we can continue to chant it even in Vaikuntha. When we go to Vaikuntha and worship the Lord there, then we can chant it there also. So this is it, the nature of devotional service. Devotees always chanting the glories of the Lord. And we can chant any mantra, we can chant the Maha Mantra, it's as good as any other mantra. Not that we all have to chant this mantra, cannot chant that mantra. And any mantra which glorifies the holy name, chants the glories of the Lord, we can chant. So then it's mentioned, the Prajumna and the people there praying to Lord Rishikesh, they tell him that you are the master of all the senses. So they said that if a woman worships you just to get a husband to satisfy her senses, then she's in illusion, she's in Maya. They should know that a husband is not going to actually give them protection. It won't be able to protect them, and it won't be able to protect their children either. This husband is not going to be able to protect their wealth, and he's not going to be able to save their life. Because he is dependent himself on time, and he's dependent on the modes of nature, and all of these things are under the Supreme Lord. So Lakshmi Devi, who composed this verse, she's saying she feels compassion towards women.
So Lakshmi Devi, she
And she feels especially sorry for those women who worship the Lord just to get a good husband.
She feels compassion
women, they want their thinking, they'll be happy if they have children and if they have money and they have a long life.
一个妇女们，如果她们认为自己有孩子、有富裕、有长寿，她们就会觉得这是快乐。
But they cannot get that. They cannot guarantee that they'll get all this.
她们不可能得到这些。
The husband cannot guarantee to give them all of these things.
一位丈夫不可能给予她们全部这些。
In the material world, the husband is also under the control of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We see sometimes in the material world, the man may have a wife, but he's not able to maintain his wife. And sometimes even they have children, they cannot maintain the children, they cannot provide for them. So actually the real husband of all women is Krishna.
因此事实上所有的女人唯一的真正的丈夫是 Krishna。
So because the gopis were all liberated souls, they could understand this fact.
作为那些牧牛姑娘们 ,gopi 们他们是解脱的灵魂他们是真正能够明白这个事实的人。
So they rejected their material husbands, and they took Krishna as their real husband.
因此他们拒绝他们物质的丈夫接受 Krishna 为他们真正的丈夫。
So Krishna is the real husband not only of the gopis, but of all living entities.
因此 Krishna 不仅是 gopi 们的丈夫而且他是每一位生物真正的丈夫。
Because Krishna is the real Purush, and we are all the Prakriti. Krishna is the male, and we are all female.
Krishna 是 Purush, 我们这些生物都是 Prakriti. Krishna 是真正的男性，而我们所有的人都是女性。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna describes Krishna as the Purush.
就像在《博伽梵歌》中，阿尔朱那说 Krishna， 称呼 Krishna 为 Purush。
Param Brahm, Param Dham, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavam, Purusham, Shasvatam, Divyam, Madhi, Daivam, Acham, Vibhu. Arjuna is appreciating the position of Krishna. He said, you are the Supreme Brahman.
Arjuna, 在这个博伽梵歌十点十二中，他非常欣赏 Krishna 的这种至尊的定位。他说，您是至尊的 Brahma。
You are the supreme abode.
您是至尊者。
You are
至高无上的居所。
You're the absolute truth.
您是绝对的真理。
You are the eternal divine person.
您是永恒的至尊的人。
You are the unborn.
您无生。不经出生。
And you are all pervading beauty.
您是遍存万有的美丽。
So we're all female. Krishna is the enjoyer. He's the Purush. We are meant to be enjoyed by Krishna. So Krishna is the husband and we are all the wives.
我们都是女性。Krishna 是 Purush. 我们是 Prakriti. Krishna 是所有的享受者。我们存在就是为了 Krishna 的享受。
So if a woman wants a material husband for her protection, then she's going to be an illusion.
如果一位女人想要一位物质的丈夫来保护自己的话，她处在愚昧的虚幻之中。
And any man who wants to become the husband of a woman, he's also an illusion. To become a husband means you have to maintain the wife and the children.
成为一个男人意味着你要维系和保护你的妻子和孩子。
You have to have money and you have to be able to give them security and protect them, look after them.
你成为一个丈夫意味着你要提供财富、安全，能够给你的妻子和孩子，维系你的妻子和孩子。
So a husband can only do this, it depends on his karma, if he can do it or not. If he has the karma, then he can do it. If his karma is not good, he won't be able to do it.
一个男子他必须要有好的 karma, 他才能够完全的做到这一点。如果他有好的 karma, 他可以做到，但是如果他没有的话，他很难以做到，他依靠他的 karma。
So it depends on our past activities, if we have the right karma to be able to maintain a family and look after a wife.
因此要维系他的妻子和孩子，这个男的，这个丈夫得依靠他过去的这些前程活，是否有过去很好的这些行为。
But we,
we
cannot do it just simply on our own, by our own efforts. We need Krishna's mercy. So, but because we have the desire to get married and to have a family, to have a wife or have a husband, so Krishna allows these things.
因为我们想要有结婚的欲望，想要有妻子、丈夫、孩子，所以 Krishna 允许我们的这个欲望。
So Krishna provides everything according to our quota, according to our karma.
因此 Krishna 根据我们的业报提供我们的这些。
Krishna says in Ishopanishad, right? Ishopanishad said,Isavashyam idam sarvam yat kincha jagatyam jagat tena chaktena panchita magridaha kashatitanam. Everything animate and inanimate within the universe is controlled and owned by the Lord.
物质世界有眼的一切都来自于至尊主的控制。
But we should only take what is necessary for ourselves, and we shouldn't take more because it's not ours, it belongs to Krishna. So Krishna knows what is our qualification to receive, and he gives us according to our qualification.
主 Krishna 知道我们的资格，他根据我们的资格提供给我们这一切。
So we should be satisfied with what is given by the grace of Krishna.
我们应该对于 Krishna 所给予我们的这一切感到满足。
So we should remember Krishna is the original master and the husband of everyone.And we are all his servants. Somebody's a husband, somebody's a wife, but we're all under his control. And our senses are under the control of Lord Rishikesh.
我们的感官也在主 Rishikesh 的控制之下。
He is the master of the senses, so he is the actual husband.
他是感官之主，他是真正的丈夫。
Okay, so we will stop here. We'll ask if there's any questions.
暂时还没有收到问题，我们稍等一下。
Good day， 我有一个问题。
嗯。
丁半宁，就是在上一章。 章之中，在无讲述的这个恒河的降落之中，恒河之水能够立即净化一个人的心意，脱离物质污染。但是在今天的这个圣帕帕德的要旨中，我们听到说恒河之水不能够净化一个人的物质依附的心意。如何，我们到底应该如何理解恒河之水的这种净化力？ So in the last chapter, the five canto 17 chapter and verse 1, in the verse, it says that the Ganges water can purify the heart immediately. But today we said in the Prabhupada's purport, he said that the Ganges water can't purify the material heart. So how to understand?
Well, he said it will take a long time. The water of the Ganges, that's going to take a long time. You have to bathe for a long time to purify the heart. But the association of a devotee can purify him immediately.
就是说，恒河之水虽然能够净化，但是需要花很长的时间。但是与奉献者的联谊却能够立即净化。
Association of devotees is very powerful. Acts just like you get an injection in the body, and then it goes right through the whole body very quickly.
就像我们和奉献者的联谊能够立即净化一个人的心，就像我们如果身上去注射一个什么的话，会立刻起到效果。
So bathing in the Ganga is very good. Yeah, it's very good. Bathe regularly in the Ganges is very nice, but it's going to take a long time to purify the heart.
在恒河水里沐浴是非常好的。但是确实是需要花很长的时间能够净化掉内心。
It's good for the physical body, you know, physically, materially, you get a lot of benefit.
从躯体上来讲，对恒河之水对身体是非常有益的。
Benefits the digestion, benefits the nervous system.All of these things, the subtle body is greatly benefited.
能够对于你的消化非常有帮助，对你的精微躯体也会有很好的净化力。
But the spiritual body, that will take long time.
但是灵性的这个躯体需要花很长时间。从灵性上来讲，需要花很长的时间。
This is also stated. There's a song. That song, Vaishnava Vignapti, by Narottam Das Thakur. And Narottam Das Thakur describes the same thing, that the water of the Ganges can purify after a long time, but the association of the Vaishnava can purify immediately.
Narottam Das Thakur 也写了同样的一首歌曲。说恒河之水需要花很长的时间能净化一个人，但是与奉献者的联谊却能立即净化一个人。Okay, thank you, Rudy. Question comes. So, first question from Dopati. 感恩咕噜，顶拜您的莲花族，感恩翻译的服务。我们还没有纯粹之前。是依靠主的仁慈和我们的业报活着吗？纯粹奉献者完全依赖的是主的仁慈，是吗？ Thanks Guru Dev, a basis to your notice faith. While we are not become a pure devotees, before we become pure, we depend the Lord's mercy and our karma. Is that right?
Before we become a devotee.
Before we become pure, we depend the Lord's mercy and our karma.
Well, before we become pure, the process of becoming pure is by doing sadhana. So if we do sadhana, if we do good spiritual practice, that will help us to become pure.
我们是通过 sadhana 来变得纯粹。如果再成为我们的程序是通过做规范修习，我们逐渐的变得纯粹。
Now, our karma may, our karma, for example, we have some parabdha karma, that means it's already manifest in the body. We have some bad habits or bad nature, you know, so there are things which are there in the body. Maybe even somebody may be diseased or deformed. It's there in the body. That's karma. It's already manifest in the body.
关于我们的业报，有一个业报，有一些业报是展示的，比如说他身体有一些疾病，而这个疾病就是已经展示出的这种业报。
So we may think that karma is restricting our devotional service.
所以我们有时候会认为这个业报阻止了我们的奉献服务。
But actually, that karma does not need to restrict our devotional service.
但是事实上，这个业报并不能阻止我们的奉献。
Even though we may be diseased, we may be handicapped or deformed, but still we can do devotional service.
即便我们生病了，我们仍然可以做一些奉献服务。
We can hear about Krishna. We can chant.
我们可以聆听 Krishna. 我们可以唱诵。
Maybe we're not able to go to temple, but we can still worship Krishna wherever we are.
或许我们不能够去庙里，但是呢，我们仍然可以做一些我们当下的一些服务。
There are no material conditions for devotional service.
对于奉献服务来说，没有物质的条件的限制。
You don't need to be intelligent, you don't need to be born in a good family, any position, you can take up devotional service.
你不必要有一个很好的出身，你也不必要有很好的智力，任何的处境下、阶段下，你都可以从事奉献服务。
We see, for example, Mograri, the hunter, how he was very cruel in killing animals.
我们听到的一个例子是 Mograri， 他是一个猎人，他非常的残忍，猎杀动物。
And after he got the mercy of Narada Muni and he started to chant the holy name, he developed so many good qualities.
在得到 Narada Muni 的仁慈之后，他开始唱诵主的圣名，他由此发展了很多非常好的品质。
Right. That he would not even step on little insects if they were on his path.
他在这个行走的路上甚至不会伤害到一个昆虫。
So we were just saying this evening that one who is a devotee, he has to have the qualities of a devotee.
今天我们也讲到了，如果一个人是奉献者的话，他会有很多这些奉献者的品质。
So by our karma, we have certain qualities, but karma is not eternal.
由通过我们的业报，我们可以得到一些的品质，但是我们的业报并不是永恒的。
We can change all of that karma by devotional service.
通过奉献服务，我们可以改变我们的业报。
There's a verse in the Brahma Samhita.Yastvendra gopa matavendra aho swakarma bandhana rupa palapajanam apanoti karmani nirdahati kintu chabakti bhajam govindam adipursam tamaham bhajamin. Lord Brahma is describing how devotional service destroys all of our karma.
在 Brahma Samhita 中有这么一个时节，刚刚Guru念到的。主 Brahma 描述了通过奉献服务可以摧毁很多不好的品质。
Devotional service just takes all that karma away. And that's why it doesn't matter where we're coming from or what our past was, we can be transformed into devotees.
奉卖服务可以摧毁掉这些卡玛，无论我们是从哪里来的，无论我们之前做过什么，奉卖服务都可以摧毁掉这些不好的卡玛。
There was a Haridas Thakur was chanting the holy name, and one prostitute came there with the intention of seducing him.
当哈尔达斯在唱哈尔达斯塔库尔在唱诵声名的时候，有一个妓女想要过来与他享受。
So Haridas Thakur had the prostitute stay there and listen to his chanting, and she sat there for 2 nights. And after 2 nights, she became a devotee herself, started to chant.
当这位妓女在那里聆听了两个晚上哈尔达斯的唱诵之后，这位妓女竟然开始转变，竟然也开始唱诵哈利·克什纳。
So Haridas told the woman, he said, you go home, give away all your things, and then you come here and sit here and chant Hare Krishna.
So Haridas Thakur 就跟这个妓女说，你回到家，放弃你所有的以前的那些，然后再来到这儿，就坐在这儿唱诵 Hare Krishna.
And the prostitute came back and she sat down, and Haridas Thakur, he left that place and he left her to sit there and chant the holy name.
当这个妓女回到家，然后再来到哈尔达斯塔库的地方的时候，哈尔达斯塔库离开了那个地方，让妓女留在哈尔达斯以前的那个地方，开始唱诵圣名。
So, we see in the modern times, we get people who come to Krishna consciousness. Sometimes they were taking drugs, they were drug addicts, they become devotees.
我们看到当今现代的这个社会，有一些人来成为奉献者，在他们成为奉献者之前，他们吸毒。
But they give everything up to become a devotee, and they do valuable service for the Krishna consciousness movement.
但是他们放弃了所有这些行为，他们成为一个奉献者，为 Krishna 做一些非常有价值的奉卖服务。
So karma is not an obstacle.To us doing devotional service.
因此 karma 不是我们的做奉卖服务的障碍。
And the same way, karma doesn't really, it's not by karma that you can do devotional service. You may say, oh, somebody's got good karma, so they can do devotional service. Doesn't mean that. Good or bad karma won't help us be a devotee.
karma 也不是让我们从事奉卖服务的原因。有些人认为，我有了一个好的业报，有了一些条件之后，我再去做奉卖服务，不是这样的。不管是好的业报还是坏的业报，都不应该是我们做奉卖服务的原因。
Devotional service doesn't depend on anything material.
奉卖服务不依赖于任何的物质方面。
Of course, the mercy of the pure devotees is very special.
但是主 Krishna 的奉献者的仁慈却是很特别的。
If we get the mercy of the pure devotees, then that can really help us to advance.
如果我们能够得到一位纯粹奉献者的仁慈的话，我们是真的能够进步的。
So the mercy of the pure devotees is given to everyone. We have to take advantage. Who wants to take advantage of the mercy of the pure devotee?
因此主的纯粹奉献者的仁慈是给予每一个人的，我们应该很好的利用这个机会。
Not everybody wants to take the mercy of the pure devotee.
不是每一个人都想抓住这个机会得到纯粹奉献者的仁慈的。
Sometimes people come to Krishna consciousness and they come with many material desires.
有一些人来到 Krishna 知觉，他们来的时候有很多的物质愿望。
But the pure devotee wants to take away these material desires.
但是纯粹奉献者想拿走这些物质愿望。
But we want to hold on to them. We say, no, we want to hold on to our material desires.
但是我们总是喜欢想抓住这些物质愿望，不要拿走我的物质愿望。
So you have to consider everything. Devotional service is, it's not so easy to understand what is Krishna's plan for everyone.
所以我们应该理解这个奉爱服务有时候不那么容易，我们要理解 Krishna 的计划，对于每一个人的计划是什么。
But Krishna certainly desires to bring people to Krishna consciousness.
当然 Krishna 肯定是希望有愿望想把每一个人带到 Krishna 知觉之中的。
So we don't know exactly his plan, how he's going to arrange it, but that's Krishna's hope to bring us all back home, back to Godhead.
我们不知道 Krishna 的这个仁慈和计划是什么。我们就把所有的人，但是 Krishna 希望每一个人都回归家园，回归受生。Then she asked, Dupati asked, Are pure devotees totally depend on the mercy of the Lord?
Yes, the pure devotee should totally depend on the mercy of the Lord.
是的，纯粹奉献者是完。应该完全依赖主的仁慈。
Everything is the mercy of the Lord.
所有的一切都是主的仁慈。
So the pure devotee sees that. He sees that everything that happens is the mercy of the Lord.
所有一切都是主的仁慈。纯粹奉献者能够看到一切真的就是主的仁慈。
That is the vision, of the pure devotees.That they see Krishna's arrangement, Krishna's hand.
这是一个纯粹奉献者的视域，他能够看到 Krishna 的安排。
When he's suffering, he sees Krishna's arrangement. He thinks I'm meant to suffer more, but Krishna's just giving me a little suffering.
当他遭受痛苦的时候，他认为这是 Krishna 的安排，他觉得自己本应该遭受更多的痛苦。但是 Krishna 已经让我减轻了这种痛苦。
And when we're happy, the devotee thinks that I don't deserve all this happiness. Krishna is encouraging me.
当奉献者快乐的时候，他会认为我并不应该，并不值得享受这么多的快乐。事实上是 Krishna 在鼓励我，给我一些快乐而已。
Yes. So devotee sees.Everything, the arrangement of Krishna is fully dependent. He said, even you may handle me roughly by your embrace. Oh, Lord Chaitanya prays in Shikshastikam like that, that even you may make me brokenhearted by not being present. You're free to do whatever you like. But you're always my Lord, unconditionally.
一个奉献者的心态就是这样，就像主柴坦尼亚在八旬归之中这么说到的，无论你拥抱我是对我粗暴，离开我是叫我心碎，你仍是我的主，你喜欢怎样就怎样。
So devotional service is unconditional. It's not that we can put conditions on Krishna.
因此奉爱服务是不受条件限制的，我们不应该把这种条件限制。
That I want this. We may think I can only serve Krishna in this situation. I have to have that. No, a devotee will accept whatever position Krishna puts him.
奉献者不应该受条件限制，比如说我想要这个，我只有有了这个，我才能做奉献服务。不，奉献者不应该这样去想。
Sometimes Krishna will take away everything from the devotee.
有时候Krishna 会从奉献者这里拿走一切。
We may lose all our position and respect. We may become disgraced and dishonored.
有时候Krishna 会拿走我们所有的地位、尊敬，我们或许会并不被人所尊敬。
And we see how the gopis, they were put in disgrace and dishonored because Krishna called them.Into the forest in the night.
就像 Gopi们失去了这种尊敬，因为 Krishna 在晚上的时候把他们叫到了森林里面去。
So for a young woman, that's very disgraceful. to be seen going in the forest with a young man.
对于一些年轻的女孩子，晚上和一个年轻的男子在一起是很不好的。
But the gopis only thought, what does Krishna want? They didn't think about what they want. They thought only how to please Krishna.
但是 gopi 们姑娘们只想着 Krishna 需要什么，她只想取悦 Krishna.
So you can only satisfy Krishna by pure devotion.
你只有通过纯粹的奉献服务才能够取悦 Krishna.
And pure devotion is uninterrupted, it's constantly, you have to do it constantly, and it's without any material condition.
而纯粹的奉献服务是持续不断的不受打扰的奉献服务。
We're
你应该连续不断的做奉献服务。
We're not telling Krishna, I have to get something, you have to give me this, I have to get that. No, we don't want anything from Krishna.
我们不会跟 Krishna 说，请你给我这个，我需要这个来做奉献服务。不，这不是。Krishna 不会给予我们这些。
We just want to serve Krishna.
我们只是想去服务 Krishna.
Yeah.
Next question.
Yeah.
From Sati Mataji. Dear Gurudev, 吉宁东风的 Tirtha Pada Prabhu 为 Krishna 种植了大米，现在已经收割了。劳动中一直念诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗，除草都是自己用手清除，没有用任何的农药。他想以成本价卖给奉献者。请问 Gurudev 这样做可以吗？他想问这样做是奉献服务吗？是服务奉献者吗 ？Dear Gurudev， 吉宁东风 Tirtha Prabhu planned some rice for Krishna and now it happened to harvest. When he doing this.He is always chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. And during his, he never used any other chemical medicine. And he want to sell this rice to the devotees without to make money for this, just sell for his real price.He wants to ask whether he can do this. And if he do this, is devotional service or is like serving the devotees?
Well, yes, he can do this. And it's karma. Devotional service is not just the physical activity.Devotional service, it depends on the attitude, the consciousness, that we do it for Krishna.
是的，他可以这样做。但是，就是说奉献服务不是躯体的这种活动，是他的意识。他的意识应该是取悦 Krishna 和奉献者。
So is his consciousness that he will make money and he will...profit on it, or is this consciousness that he's just doing it for Krishna?
He said he wants to sell this to the devotees without profit, just the natural price, no profit.
Well, I don't know, it's up to the devotees if they want to get his rice, you know, you have to see.
我们得看一看奉献者到底看是否需要这个大米，我们得看一看。
We just grew a lot of rice here in Mayapur, on the land here in Mayapur, they grew a lot of rice, and they got 40 sacks of rice from the harvest.
40
sacks.
Okay.我们在马亚普这里也经历了一次大的丰收，然后呢，有很多的这个大米，有 拜吧，四十。
Yeah. So the thing is the rice, of course, after you harvest it, it has to be boiled, and you have to, you know, there's a processing required. Before, you don't just harvest the rice and then you can cook it. They have a big boiler thing where they have to boil the rice to take off the skin from the rice.
嗯，不是说丰收了就好，这些大米收割了之后还有一套程序，比如说你还得把这个大米的壳给剥掉等等这一些事情。
So it's a lot of work.
这个是有很多的工作需要做的。
Farming is the most pious profession.
务农，农耕是一个是非常非常虔诚的活动。
And we know farmers in general, they have to work quite hard, and they don't make much money.
我们知道农民他们工作得很辛苦，但是并没有获得很赚取很多的利润。
So if the devotees want to buy some rice from you, then okay, very nice.
如果奉献者想从你这儿买一些米的话，非常好。
But they have to see what is the quality of your rice. Some rice is good and some rice is not so good.
我们得看一看你的米的质量好不好。有一些米的质量很好，有一些米不是怎么好。
Some rice has a bad smell when you cook it, it's not very good.
有一些米烹饪的时候它闻起来并不是很好。
So it will depend on how the devotees find the quality of your rice, if they want to buy it more.
我们得看一看奉献者买你的米的时候，他们觉得你的米的质量怎么样，是否想买更多的米。
Is this devotional service that you grow rice and sell it to devotees? Yeah. Well, if you use the money from the rice, they pay you the money for the rice and then they use it to grow more rice, okay. Then it's devotional.
如果这个奉献者从你这儿买的米，然后你拿着这个米继续种这个大米的话，这是可以的，这是奉献。
You offer the results of your work to Krishna. Devotional service is more concerned with hearing and chanting and remembering Krishna.
奉献服务更多的关注点是聆听、唱诵、记忆 Krishna.
Farming is more like karma yoga.
务农更多的倾向于是 karma yoga.
Right, you're doing the work, you're growing the rice, and you offer some result for Krishna.
你工作，你务农，你把一些活动的结果供奉给 Krishna。
But what is actually devotional service begins with hearing and chanting.
事实上，实际上的奉献服务起源于聆听和唱诵。
So when you're farming, when you're up there, when you're in the fields planting the rice and harvesting the rice, if you're chanting and remembering the holy name every moment, then it's devotional service.
如果你在务农的时候，时刻的聆听和唱诵奉献服务，这个是奉献服务，这是真正的奉献服务。
But more likely your farming is karma yoga.
如果只是务农，那是属于 karma yoga。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Chandra Vinasi Madhiji. 顶拜 Guru Day， 请教 Guru Day， 怎么才能完全吸收到 Guru 的仁慈呢？感恩您。I want to a basis to Guru Day. I want to ask, how can I fully absorb all the mercy of the Guru?
By following all the instructions.
通过完全的追随 Guru 的训示，你可以完全的吸收guru的仁慈。
But remember, guru is not just simply Diksha guru, but guru is also Srila Prabhupada, who is the ultimate Shiksha guru.
Guru, 你要记住 ,guru 并不指的只是启迪灵性导师。Guru 意味着训示灵性导师以及圣帕帕德。圣帕帕德是训示灵性导师。
So we give initiation in order to connect the devotee more closely to Prabhupada.
我们给予奉献者启迪是让奉献者能够和帕帕更加的接近。
So we want you to get the full mercy from Srila Prabhupada.
我们希望你能够得到全然的来自圣帕帕德的仁慈。
And the more you follow Prabhupada's instructions, the more you will get the mercy.
你越多的追随圣帕帕德的训示，你越多的得到仁慈。
So you have to read Prabhupada's books carefully and understand his teachings.
因此你应该小心仔细地阅读圣帕帕德的这个书籍。
The main books are the Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, and Nectar of Devotion.
这些主要的书籍包括圣典薄伽，薄伽梵歌、圣典薄伽瓦坛、永恒的柴坦尼亚经、分外的甘露。
So study these books very carefully, and it's very good also you take some of the courses like Bhakti Shastri and learn all these books.
仔细地学习这些书籍，同时去学习一些课程，比如说分外的经典课程 Bhakti Shastri 课程，你可以学习所有的这些书经典。
And don't just think that you study it one time, you know everything.
也不要想着你只学一次你就可以能够懂得一切。
You study it, and then study it again, then maybe you have to teach it, and you have to teach it several times, then gradually you start to know.
你学一遍然后再学，学完之后你甚至应该教了几次之后你才有可能开始知道。
So,There's so much to be absorbed, so much to learn. We have to study very carefully.
We have a lot of need to learn, a lot of need to absorb. So we should be very careful to learn.
So Prabhupada's small books, they help, they're like an introduction to prepare us for the big book.
这些小书是一些介绍，让我们来了解这些大书。
So often we may begin with reading the small book, and when we read the small book and we find it interesting, then we will want to read the big book.
我们先学习这些小书，有了这些介绍，然后变得有兴趣之后，我们去学习这些大的书籍。
So it's a very good exercise for devotees to study and to read the books together. Not only just reading, but studying and understanding properly.
对于奉献者来说，学习研习这些书籍是一个很好的锻炼。不仅仅只是阅读它，大家在一起要理解它。
Now, if we've read it carefully, then we should be able to explain what the book is saying.
如果我们能够很好的阅读它的话，我们应该准备着去解释这些书籍。
So it's a good test for us, how much we're learning, how much we're understanding.
这也是一个很好的，就是解释，这也是一个很好的测试，来测试我们到底学到了什么样的层面。
Of course, it's not that we have to become bookworms, not that we have to become scholar or very knowledgeable. The important thing is we have to cultivate our devotion, our love for Krishna.
当然，我们并不是要成为一个大的学者，一个书呆子或者是什么样。我们重要的是，我们要培养我们对 Krishna 的奉爱之情。
Some people do wonderful service. They have a wonderful service attitude. They may hardly have time to read.
有一些奉献者，他们做了很多美好的这些奉献服务，他们或许真的没有时间去学习阅读。
They're so busy. They're so doing so much service for Krishna.
他们做了很多的奉爱服务为 Krishna.
But they don't get.Hardly time to look at the books or to hear the classes. They're always active serving.
但是他们并没有那么多的时间去阅读或者参加这些课程。
But they're very great devotees. They have wonderful love for Krishna. They're very attached to the holy name.
但是他们都是非常好的奉献者，他们对 Krishna 的圣名有很强烈的依附。
And they're very steady in their devotional service.
他们的奉爱服务也非常的稳定。
Next
question from Gopinath Priya Mataji, 顶拜 Gurudev 的莲花族。我们只满足于自己的生活所需，不要贪婪，满足自然而然。自然而然得来的物质所得，可是怎么区分什么是合适的，什么是贪婪的？感恩Guru的解释。Obeisant to Guru's lotus feet, we say we just satisfied what we need and not to be greed, and be satisfied with natural income. So, but how to distinguish what is what is suitable and what is greed?
Well, what comes by honest endeavor without, without lying and cheating people, without going against all kinds of laws, just doing everything in the proper manner, in an honest manner, and then whatever comes by the grace of Krishna, that is our quota.
一个人他通过诚实的劳动所得，并没有通过欺骗或者说说谎或者说其他的一些不合法的手段得到的这个财富，这个被称为是我们的业报所得。
Or if you have to endeavor to such an extent that you have no time for any, that you have to put so much effort to maintain yourself, that all day and all night working and going to great extremes, efforts just to get money, then this is not our proper quota.
但是如果你花了巨大的努力，比如说焦虑，占用你很多的时间，充满了很多的危险而得到的这种财富，这个不属于你的业报，这个属于贪婪。
We should keep a balanced life. We should have some time to read and chant.
我们应该让自己的生活保持平衡，要留给一些时间给我们念诵和阅读。
We should have some time.For proper maintenance of the body, and at the same time, we have to work.
We need to have some time to maintain our body, and then go to work.
Maybe you have to get some time for walking or for exercise.
We need to walk or do some exercise.
You should have some time when you can cook.And be with your family, be with your child.
We need some time to be with your family, to cook food.
If you have no time to even see your child and to hold your child in your arms, then all the time working, this is not good.
如果你花你完全没有时间照顾你的孩子，甚至让你的孩子跟你有一个拥抱的话，完全投身在你的工作之中，这并不好。
Of course, we see all over the world, women all working, then hardly ever at home. They have to go to work all day. Children are alone without their mother.
我们看到当今现代，这些妇女们全部都去工作，他们的孩子们都在家里面待着，并没有和母亲能够有很多的时间相处。
The child is put in the school with all the other children.
孩子待在学校和其他的孩子们在一起。
And the mother doesn't get a chance to bring up her own child.
这些母亲并没有时间去抚养她的，没有机会去抚养她自己的孩子。
Because she's so busy working, earning money.
她非常的忙于挣钱。
And what she's going to do with the money? She has to pay most of the money to the school for the education of the child.
但是她挣的这些钱用来干什么呢？她挣的这些钱大部分的时间都花在了她孩子去上学的这个事情上。
Is it worth it? Better the mother just stayed at home and took care of the child.
觉得这个事情值得吗？最好的是这个母亲亲自抚养这个孩子，照顾这个孩子。
So we should not over endeavor. We should be practical. Keep a balanced life. We need some material. We need to maintain ourselves materially.You need to also maintain yourself spiritually.
因此，我们不应该付出太过于过分的这种努力，为了这种物质的这种生存或者境况。我们应该有一些时间维系自己的生存，也有一些时间维系自己的灵性生活。
Okay.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from the Radha Priya Mataji, 顶拜孤乳，感恩翻译和主持的服务。对于退休的奉献者，还有必要工作赚钱吗？还是说这是贪婪？For the retired devotees, are they necessary to work for making the money, or if they do, is this greedy?
Well, retired devotees, if they're retired, then they should have if they don't have any pension, then they have to find some means to maintain themselves.
如果退休了，他没有任何的这种收入的话，他也得维系他自己。
But ideally, retirement is meant.For devotion, taking up full-time engagement in spiritual activity.
理想的情况下是一个退休的奉献者应该完全投身于奉献服务之中。
We give up the material duties and take up the spiritual duties.
他放弃物质的职责，承担起灵性的职责。
So if he's still having to make money, is he thinking, is it just for his minimum maintenance to maintain himself? Is it necessary?
所以得考虑他的这个，他赚钱维系他的生活的所需是否是必须的。
We should have some kind of community place where people who are retired, they can go and stay there, and they can do service there.
我们应该有一些奉献者有一个协会或者是组织，当人退休之后可以待在那。
Just like brahmacharis and sannyasis, they also don't work. So Vanaprastha is also not expected to work.
就像这个 Brahmachari, Sannyasi, Vanaprastha, 他们不应该工作。
They're all supposed to be maintained by the Grihasthas.
他们应该被 Grihastha 们所维系。
But their needs should be very, very minimal, very small.
但是呢，他们的需求应该是非常少的，不应该是很多的。
Because they've retired, so they don't need much to maintain themselves.
因为他们都是退休的人，所以他们不应该需要花很多的钱，或者说花很多的。
So if the grihasthas are not giving support, if the children are not there to provide for them, then they may have to find some way to generate some income for themselves.
因此，当他们的孩子或者说居士不能够维系他们的话，他们得找一些事情能够维系他们的基础的生存。
But it should be minimum, or just only enough, just so that they can maintain their life.
但是应该是最少的，只是用这个钱来，只是赚取一点钱来维系他的生活就行。
It is not very ideal. Ideally, vanaprastas are not meant to work.
但这不是理想化的。理想的状态是 ，vanaprastha 退休阶层的人不应该工作。
They're meant to go to temple. Either they can stay at home, or they can go to stay in a holy place and do service there.
他可以在家，或者也可以去圣地，在圣地从事奉献服务。
They're not meant to just sit and do nothing. They're meant to be engaged in activities.
他们不应该坐着什么都不做，他们应该从事。
We see many wonderful ladies, elderly ladies, they're retired, but they do so much service, they cook very, very nicely, they do so much, offer so much service to the devotees.
We see many good ladies, some good devotees, they retire after they are there, they can do so many delicious prasada, they are devotees.
So, retired doesn't mean we don't do anything. We still have to eat, still have to cook, you have to clean, you have to wash.
退休不意味着你什么都不做，他应该清洁，应该洗，应该要做很多的事情。Radha Priya Mataji said, this kind of condition, The retired devotees, she described, said, have the retirement money. So in this condition, whether they need to walk,
well,
if they walk,
we have to hear from them. We have to ask them, what is the need? Why they're doing it? They may have a good reason. I don't know.
因此，我们得问一问这个奉献者。他们的需求是什么？或许我们不知道他们的真正的情况是怎么样。他们为什么要去工作？我们也得问一问他们。
Okay, any other question there?
物质世界普遍是这样焦虑，太忙碌，都不是业报中的工作，感觉这种平和的工作基本没有，都想忙点多赚钱，怎样找到业报中的工作 ？In the material world, normally we are very anxiety and very busy You see, all the work are not the karma work. It feels like this kind of peace work. I can't find any work is very peaceful. Everyone want to very busy to make more money. So how do you find the work in the karma and the peaceful work?
Well, you can always try to be a farmer, take care of the cows.
你可以成为一个农民，然后照顾奶牛。
That's peaceful work.
这个是很平和的工作。
You live in the city, you're in the mode of passion. So you're associating with the mode of passion. So it's not a very good environment.
你住在城市，你和激情属性接触，所以那里不是一个很好的环境。
But you live in the countryside, you have some land, you grow some things, you can cook and eat.
但是如果你住在乡村，你耕种一些土地，你有的吃。
You don't need a lot of land. You just have to have some yard and you can grow your vegetables.
你不需要很多的土地，你只需要有你的院子，能够种你的蔬菜就行。
And you can live very nicely. You can even keep a cow, and then if you're lucky, you may get a cow that gives you milk. You can have nice milk.
你会活得非常好，然后你也可以照顾一头奶牛，这样你会有非常好的牛奶喝。
But you've chosen to live in the city, so you associate with the mode of passion. So you have to expect there will be some difficulties.
是你自己选择要住在城市的，所以你和那些激情属性的人接触，你必然会有这样的情况。
So you have to keep up your sadhana very carefully. You have to be very regulated in your spiritual practice.
因此，你应该很好地保持你的 sadhana 规范修习。
Sleep early, wake up early.
早早的睡觉，早早的起床。
Use the morning hours to chant and to read.
用早上的时间，清晨的时间去念诵和阅读。
You should have kirtan at home.
你应该在家里有唱诵。
I hope you're doing the Damodar prayer every day and offering a lamp to Lord Damodar.
I 希望你每一天都在家里唱诵这个达摩达尔的祷文，供奉一盏灯。
Very important. Householders have to be very strict in their worship.
这是非常重要的。这个家居生活应该非常小心的崇拜，仔细的崇拜。
And you should have guests come to your home sometimes, and you should give them nice prasadam.
你应该邀请一些客人来到你家，然后给予他们一些 prasadam.
Your wife should be a good cook, and she should keep the house very neat and clean.
你的妻子应该是一个很好的厨师，应该让家里变得整洁干净。
This will help you to keep more in the mode of goodness.
这些都能够帮助你更多地处在善良属性之中。
You have to be very careful to avoid passion and ignorance.
你应该非常小心地避免激情和愚昧属性的影响。
Together with the family, you should read the scriptures.
和家人在一起，和家，整个家人在一起。学习经典，读经典。
So householder life can help you to advance very, very, very nicely if you follow the principles.
如果你严格的追随，如果你追随这些原则的话，家居生活也能够让你很好的进步。
What does he say? Harivansa 说什么？
他说，我想过，但是很多人说我是异想天开，说梦话。我向我妻子也描述了这个场景，她说我太天真了，等到退休再说，我倒想试一试。He said, I also think about living in the countryside, but many people said to me it's a dream. I also described to my wife this kind of condition and countryside environment. She said to me, I'm so dream after retire and then do this, but I want to try.
Okay, very good.
很好。
Of course, it's China. In China, it's not very easy, life in the countryside.
在中国生活在农村不是很容易。
But some devotees can do it.
但是有一些奉献者可以做这个事情。
It's different from life in the city, but it's very, very pure and simple, peaceful.
这个是完全不同于城市生活。它非常的简单，而且纯净。
Okay, any other question?
No question.
我没有问题了，对。
Okay, so we will stop here tonight. Om Ganeshaya Subhuti Rai Prabhu Givaman Jantai Dufani Ganeshaya Sati Trujur Ganeshaya Sayo Dufang Shenzhu Ling Ting Wen Wenti.Vama Jufu Niman, Kartika Yua Kwaila.
Thank you, Gurudev. Thank you, Gurudev.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.